Hey everyone, welcome back in another video. Today we've got a lot of things to talk about, so let's get started. Today I want to talk about a big stack of games I've been buying in the last few months. I sold a lot of games I have before and that I don't care anymore, like PAL games, as I want to go further into Japanese only. So as the Americans one, the PAL games are generally much more expensive than their Japanese counterpart in most of the case. We can say that Mega Drive or Genesis is an exception, but I sell a lot of games and I lot another lot and I buy another lot. So let's start with Dreamcast game, as Dreamcast is one of my favorite systems. I bought two games because I already have got a big part of what I want. So the first game is Maken X, a first person shooter made by Atlus. So this game was one of the first games launched with the systems, maybe not launched but announced with the system, and when it was previewed in magazines at the time, this game amazed me. So it's finally this year that I put my hand on it, and it's a pretty cool game, a first person shooter with the character have the ability to send his soul in another characters to possess them. And so what is making this game really original, it's because we don't change weapon as we go through the game, but we can change weapon, but the only way is to send our soul into another characters to use their weapon. So it's a pretty good game, it's really cheap nowadays, so I find it relatively fun. The second one and the last one, I think, yes, is Marvel vs. Capcom. No need to go really deep into this one. I think that most of you know it. So it's an exceptional Capcom fighting game. I had it in the past, sell it, and today is mine again. Next, we've got a few PlayStation 2 games. The first one is Yoshitsuneki. It's a third person action game like Devil May Cry, maybe. Not as fun, but in a Japanese feudal time. It's a pretty good game. I fell in love with the cover, which I found very, very good, beautiful. And the fact that the game was made by Bonpresto is for me a good sign, because they made pretty good games, not all, but so it was cheap, so I bought it, and I'm glad I have done, because I played through the game for 1 hour maybe, and it's pretty good. Next, Gungrave Overdrive. This is the second game of the Gungraves series, and I always wanted to try it because I love the artworks. Gungrave is, I think, the game is based on an anime, but maybe it's an anime that was based on the game. I don't remember, but it's a third person. Action game like Yoshitsuneki, but with a totally different plot. We are in the present time, and this character is, I think, a vampire. And there's two other, which we can see here, but the camera won't make the focus. It's made by Red Entertainment, which the fan of the PC Engine will know who they are. They made the Bong Games, or PC Engine, and Tengai Maikyo. So, like Bond Presto, maybe more, Red, bye bye. Well, here it is. Next, three games for the PlayStation 1. The first one being Suzu Managatari. This game is a RPG made by Capcom. And I don't know about this game until a video on the net, on YouTube, about Japanese man going to Hard Earth and pick games, like there is many. And I fall in love with the cover, but I think very charming. The game is pretty beautiful too, with sweet 2D graphism, but I can say lot of things about that game because I don't have the abilities to play it with my little Japanese. Next game is Shaman King Spirits of Shaman. It's a fighting game in the Shaman King series. It's pretty good. What I think is what makes me buy this game is, first, I love Shaman King, and when I was a teenager I had all the mangas, and second one, you won't see this because the camera will not focus, of course, but the graphism are like the 2D makes me think about the Saturn, which is one of my favorite system. So, when I played it, I don't know what it will be, but it's a really good game. Not as deep as a true fighting game, but it's a good game. So, as easy to ship, I can't tell you to not buy it, because I find it good. Next, a really good game too. Ridge Racer Type 4, which is very easy to have, really cheap, but it's pretty rare to have the hobby, so I'm glad I have it. So arcade racing game, I had it when it was launched, although I'm not a big racing game fan, but this one had something. It's a really, really good game. I love it. Next, why not talking about Game Boy games? Or just one. This game, Flipool, made by Taito. I would not have buy this game without the video of Kichoyoken that covers the Famicom version of the game, but I had to. And this game is complete. It's a puzzle game with a pretty original way of playing, but I will not try to explain it in English, sorry. Maybe you can watch a long play or something, or better go to see the Kichoyoken video about the Famicom game. It's pretty much the same, and I'm glad to have it. Next, only one PC Engine game, sadly, because I love my PC Engine. It's maybe my favorite system. My favorite systems are Mega Drive, PC Engine, Super Famicom, Famicom, Dreamcast, Saturn. So I've got a lot of favorite systems, and I love Neo Geo CD. So back to the game. It's Hand in the Sky. I wanted it since a long time, and finally got the chance to have it for a good price. It's complete. It's a shooting game. For the PC Engine game, the better is to watch the booklet, because there are no screenshots. So you better to know the game you buy. So it's a shooting game with a pretty original way of playing, because you've got a weapon in hand, and you've got a button to shoot with it, and another button to orientate your arm all around you. And the originality of the game is you can't stay in the bottom of the screen and shoot everything, because your opponents will come from all sides. So it's a very very memory based game, pretty difficult like all of these, but the graphics are great, even though I don't like the moving scrolling, because if you go to the up of the screen, the scrolling will go faster, and I don't really like this type of game. But it's really hard, pretty cool, so go for it if you are playing. Next, we've got a Saturn game, but what a game. Let me push some, make some space. This game is no less than Cyberbots. So Cyberbots is a Capcom fighting 2D fighting game, which is really not really known, because the game is not in here. Because I don't know. First of all, he never left Japan, and at the time, Capcom launched a very very big selection of fighting games that were all great. So maybe it was the tree that was hide by the forest. I don't know. This expression doesn't mean anything. So this is a collector edition with this. I don't know what it says in English. Diorama, and this artbook. And this artbook is magnificent. I love it. Lots and lots of fabulous design, and maybe even some figures in it. Don't know if it was sold or not, but like a lot of drawings, etc. Very very good art book. I like them. I've got quite a few. So sorry for the technical problem. Here I'm back with the game itself. So as I said before, it's a 2D fighting game with mechas, and it's pretty good. I'm not really into fighting games because I love them, but I don't have the time to really go through the game. I already like shooters, so we have to choose. But it's really good. The game is actually not that expensive. and I've got the chance to buy the collector edition from a Japanese seller for 40 bucks, which I think is a really good price. So pretty happy to have them. Next, we go to the Famicom with three games loose. First, we got King's Knight, which is a shoot 'em up from Square. I thought that Highlander was the only one, but no, they made one for the Famicom. Even though I think this game was ported by Square, and because it exists in the MSX format, and I don't know, but I don't think that Square developed for the MSX. Tell me in the comments if you know. The second game is SD Gundam Seiseiken, I think. And it's an action adventure game, pretty average to be honest, but really cheap, so why not? And the final game is a Nintendo Classic Ice Climber. Listen to this. I love the Famicom games, I love the colors of the Famicom games. This one is a don't know, puzzle action game maybe, where you begin in the bottom of the screen and you have to climb, like they said, like it is said in the title, you have to climb at the top of the screen, and you have to break ice blocks to go up, and there is enemies and etc. It's a pretty good game. I like it actually. Next, we've got Famicom Complete games. I've got quite a few. So, the first one, Gyrodin. This game is a shoot 'em up made by Taito. And it's pretty rude one. Not a very really good game. The complete version of the game must have a coin here. Don't care. And I'm happy to have it because nonetheless it's a shooting game, but not a really great one. Next, Mag Max. This game is a shooting game too, made by Nichibutsu. And it's a pretty good one, not very good, but pretty. You start as a little piece of an armor and or a mech, and as the time goes by you can pick up some elements to power up, but as you do that your character will grow in size, so you will be more easy for the foes to be shoot. So it's a pretty good game, I like it. Next, Volgard. Still a shoot 'em up by DBSoft. Don't know what they do. I've got not a lot to say about this game because it's not really a good game. It's not bad either, but well, if you find it cheap, maybe give it a try if you are a shooter fan. The next are good games. The first one is Thunderbirds. So maybe it's not a very good game, but I love Thunderbirds, so I find it better than it really, really is, but maybe. But it's a pretty good looking game. It's a pretty competent shooter too. And it's a bit random about. So look at this, it's pretty beautiful. It's hard, but I like it. Next, this game is not a shooting game. It's Challenger, made by Hudson. It's an action adventure game with different type of gameplay, 100 levels I think, and a lot of secrets. It's a really good game, I like it a lot, and I'm pretty happy to have it complete because I already buy it cartridge only, and now I've got it complete. And not the last one, but I think the game I love the most in the stack is Hector 87, complete in box with a magnificent blue cartridge. Don't know if the camera make honor to that, but it's really beautiful cartridge, and it's part of collecting Famicom, the fact of liking the colors, etc. It's a charm, I think. So Hector 87 is a shooting game, part of the Hudson Soft like Star Soldier, and what is the name of the second game? Star Force and Star Soldier, yes. The third one is Hector 87, and it's a shooting game with a caravan stage mod, and it's beautiful, it's hard, and I find it's a good game. Next is a piece of collection for me, not an expensive one, and I don't think that a lot of people will find it interesting, but I do. So this game is TM Network Live in Powerball. It was sold in this metal case, and the game is brand new. This is an adventure game, like a point and click, based on this Japanese band, which I think the name is TM Network. And what makes this game pretty interesting, it's because it's a bicolor cartridge. And maybe that makes me strange people, but really like. I was aware of the Japanese version of Dragon's Lair that already had, I think it's purple and orange cartridge, but there is another one, bicolor, and maybe others. So as I can have it for pretty cheap, I think it was 10 or 15 bucks. I bought it. Let me clean a little the space and I go back. So next we've got the Super Famicom games. I've got a lot of classics games in this stack because I like them, maybe. First is F-Zero. So I'm not really into F-Zero, but I think that the first race music team, I think it's New City, is a great theme. So I like to have them with the original setting on my system and CRT. So I picked it up. It was pretty cheap, like 7 or maybe 8 bucks. So, and it's a good game. I'm not really into, but it's a good game, so I picked up. The second one is Star Fox, because like everyone, when I was a child, I played Star Fox Star Fox like hell, and it's a pretty good game. I don't I think that the 3D doesn't age very well, but it's still a good game from the time. The next game is still a classic. It's Takahashi Meijin Nobukenjima, I think. So this game is an action platform game with songs by Yuzo Koshiro, and it's a pretty good game, I like it. All those games are complete with the manual, etc. But it's not like the Famicom game where we can enjoy the colors of the cartridge. They are all the same on this game, so I don't put them up. The next game is a really good one. It's Kirby. I don't know what the name, but it's Deluxe, Super Deluxe. So it's a compilation of I think it's six games. Some are mini games and some are full length games. I wanted it since long time, but it's one of these games that people are asking a bit too much, because Kirby is very popular in Japan and everywhere as well. So when I found it cheap, I take it, and I'm glad I did. The next one is Mickey Magical Adventure, I think. This is a platform game made by Capcom. It's a pretty good game, and I like Capcom and Super Famicom, so I can have it pretty cheap, so I take it. And in the same time, I take the sequel, which is the Great Circus Mystery starring Mickey and Minnie. And it's more or less the same, except that in this game Mickey can put a lot of clauses that change his abilities. It's a pretty cool feature, and I first want to make a playthrough of the first one, and then I will make the second game. Next we got an American game, and it's in Japanese version, of course, but it's Smash TV. I played a lot of this game when I was a kid. It's a really, really good game in multiplayer mode, and I'm happy to finally have it, because in Japan, American games portrayed on the Super Famicom are often expensive. So when I found this one for maybe 15 bucks, I take it, because it's a really good game. Next we got an amazing puzzle game. It's Panel de Pain, which is known in Europe and USA as Tetris Attack, I think. And Panel de Pain is a puzzle game with blocks that come from the bottom of the screen to go up, and we have a cursor that can switch two pieces, and the goal is to make at least three pieces of the same color together, to put them together. And they disappear, and the goal is to keep surviving the longest time. The first time I got the game, I put the game in the console to test it, of course, and I played it more than 10 hours, because I love this game. Cool. The next one is Mushin Senshi Gundam Wing Endless Duel. It's a fighting game made by Natsume. there is a review of this game by Kitchayoken 2. Go to see the game in action. This game is a really good game with cool graphics. I played it a lot on emulation when I was a child. So as this game is going to up in price, I'm glad to finally find it for a good price. I think I paid it 40 bucks. I don't know if it's really a good deal, but and the final Super Famicom game is, I think it's Kidu Tsukuryu, known in the West as the Emperor. So this game is a shoot 'em up. I think it's a pretty obvious ripoff of Aleste, Musha Aleste, from the Mega Drive, one of the best games in the world. And Vic Tokai made it. It's a good game on its own. I think it's pretty clear when we see this screenshot. I think that Vic Tokai tried to make their Musha Aleste. But if it's a good game, I'm happy to have it. And the final game I will show you today. Is our Mega Drive game, because I love my Mega Drive, and it's a pretty cool system to collect for. Even though, as I said before, I collect Japanese only, most of all, because when PAL or US game is exclusive, I can take it nonetheless. But the first game is Burning Force. The problem with the Mega Drive is because it is really, really expensive in Japan. Some games are no hundreds of dollars, or very, very expensive. I can't put a lot of money like that. So it's a game that I will never own. But Burning Force, it's non-pod game. It's I think it's their Space Harrier, and it's a pretty good game. Not amazing, nice cover, but the music on this game are epic, and just for that, it's worth. Next game is a very good one. It's Rocket Knight Adventures, that I'm glad to find it in my city here in France. So pretty cool. It's an amazing game. I know why it's so praised, because the graphics are amazing, the musics are great, the gameplay is character moves exactly like we want to, so it's a really, really good game. And it's one of the rare Konami games on the Mega Drive that is not very, very, very expensive. It's not a cheap game by any means, but it's not very, very expensive. The next game is an amazing one, and it's Gunstar Heroes. I love this game so much. I used to play it on the PS2, PS2, Sega Ages version, which is a game that contains Dynamite Heady, this game, and Alien Soldier. So I'm really glad to have it, and when I launched the game in the system, I clear it in the first try. It's not because it's an easy game. It's not easy. It's not very hard at all in normal mode. But I have trained on the PS2 version that I never cleared, and I clear it in the original system. It's a really good game, full of ideas, like most of Treasure's game, and I can't recommend enough this game because it's going up in value too, so grab it while you can. And the next game is a very expensive one. I found it here in France for a very good price. The guy know what it sells, it's not but he wanted to sell it and not put it in the price we can see over the internet. So this game is Undead Line. And it's a Pelletrian, I think we said in English, Shoot Them Up, aka Shoot Them Up where we work. And it's a really good Shoot Them Up. The graphics are average, the music are sometimes very, really great, sometimes pretty forgettable, but the gameplay is amazing. We've got a lot of weapons, a lot of options. The game is pretty hard, but as when you know what type of weapon is to be have at a certain moment, it becomes manageable. So I don't it today yet, but I will, I'm sure I will one day. And it's really a good game. I don't know if it's worth 300 bucks is asked for, but for the 150 I paid, I think it's a good game. That concludes this video, so a lot of things, and you know what, I've got other things to show you, so we will get back soon to see what this game are, so stay tuned, goodbye.